You see, there are about 45 charging stations in Bangalore, which is around 1 or 2 chargers for every 5 kilometers. What if I tell you that there are more than 100 charging stations for EVs in Bangalore, which is roughly 4 or 5 chargers for every 5 kilometers? But how do we find them? Come, I'll show you today. First one, Bolt. There is this startup called Bolt Earth, which provide charging stations. There are close to 40 to 45 charging stations for Bolt itself in Bangalore, which is super huge network. Now, how do I find these Bolt chargers? There is this app called Bolt Earth, where you can find the chargers nearby your location. I bet you'll be surprised to look at the number of chargers surrounding you. What's unique about the Bolt is that, along with charging your bike with the Bolt charger, you can make money with the Bolt charger. Yes, you can make money with the Bolt charger. Second option is this charger called Charzer. Its name is Charzer. And there are about roughly 20 to 25 charging stations in Bangalore. What's unique about this is that you can reserve a slot for your charging. Be it half an hour, 45 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, be it 5 hours. You can simply reserve that on the app. And it costs roughly around 30 to 35 rupees for a full charge. Similar to Bolt, Charzer has its own app where you can reserve your charging, start your charging, stop your charging. Along with, you can find stats about your charging, and it's extremely simple to use. All you have to do is scan the QR code, plug in your charger and then start charging, and then pay for the charging that you consumed, which will be around 20 to 25 rupees for a full charge. And the next charger is from the bike manufacturer Ather itself. These are the fast chargers for Ather. If you have an Ather, you can fast charge your bike, which means if your portable charger or if the dot charger for Ather, if it takes 4 hours or 5 hours to battery full your bike, fast charger will take around 45 minutes to 1 hour. But if you don't have an Ather, the fast charger is not for you. You have this 3-pin charger into which you can plug in your portable charger to charge your bike. There are around 40 chargers across Bangalore, but the problem is these chargers are not as widely spread as the Bolt or Charzer, because the Bolt and Charzer are basically 3-pin ports, and this is the actual charger, the fast charger for Ather along with the 3-pin port. Now, how do you find these chargers? Well, there is this app called Ather Grid in which you can find the chargers nearby your location. This app also tells you if the charger is vacant, if it is being used, or if the charger has some repairs. For the time being, these chargers are completely free, but once they start charging, I assume it will be about twice of what the charger or Bolt is charging, which is about 45 or 50 rupees for a full charge. I don't know. Let's see once they start charging. For now, it's free. So whenever you find these chargers and go there, you will probably find some demand for these chargers, people waiting near these chargers, because you know it's free. And this is a charger from Ola called Ola Hyper Network. The only problem with this is that if you have an Ola, it's a heaven. It's a fast charger, you can completely make use of it. If you don't have an Ola, this charger is not for you, because there is no other 3-port charger or fast charger built for other bikes. And there are not many Hyper Network chargers of Ola across the city. They are building now, probably in 6 months or 1 year of time, there will be enough chargers across the city. Have you tried this charger before? Please do let us know in the comments below. There is this new player in this charging station segment of EV called the Shell Recharge. The petrol station provider Shell has also entered into the market of EVs with this Shell Recharge. These are the charging stations present across the Shell petrol bunks. I mean, there are not so many right now, they are building it. But even this is extremely simple to use, and there is an app for this as well. All you have to do is scan the QR code, plug in your portable charger, and then pay for the charge you consumed. Simple. These chargers are not so widely spread as a Bolt, Charzer and Ather, but I think it will take some time. Now, this is a good thing that the charging stations are coming within the petrol bunks, which makes it very obvious to find. Have you tried this before? There is this one more charger called Electric Pay. They also offer a similar thing which the Bolt and Charzer offers. They'll provide this 3-pin port. You have to scan the QR code, pay for the charge consumed, and you can charge your bike. Problem with these chargers is that right now they are offering these chargers mostly to apartments and the residential complexes, not many for the public use. If you have searched for this a charger watching my previous video, you might probably not have found one because there is not one for the public use. When I tried myself, out of 10, probably like 9 were in the residential area. The one which is left out wasn't working. You see, now we have all these chargers, Bolt, Charzer, Ather, Ola, but are all these chargers solving the actual problem that we need? Because with all these chargers right now, at least the street has one charger at least in the city. Are these adding any value? The biggest problem currently with the charging infrastructure of EVs as an EV ecosystem itself is that each bike has its own charging socket and voltage. Every petrol bike has same port that makes them literally use every single petrol bunk. But with EVs, Ather has its own charging port, Revolt has its own, and Ola has its own, and so on. So within the segment of EVs itself, there are multiple segments right now. I can't use the fast chargers of Ola and they can't use the fast chargers of Ather. And this is making these third party charging station providers to provide just this 3-pin power socket rather than a charger or a fast charger. And this is making the charging infrastructure for EVs extremely poor and sluggish. Right now we are literally calling these 3-pin power socket providers as charging stations, which literally any local electrician would do for us. Just imagine, if all the EVs have the same charging port, the one that you connect to your bike, and not only the Ola and Ather, lot more startups would come up to provide a much more sophisticated infrastructure for EV charging. When that happens, range anxiety of all EVs would vanish. And when that happens, a lot more people would buy EVs. And when that happens, you can plan your EV long rides without a single worry about the charge left on your bike. Lot more interesting bikes and cars in EVs would come up since the charging infrastructure is already in place. What do you guys think about it? Please do let us know in the comments below.